Coming two of them back to back.
Yeah.
We talked to Jackson Rathbone. Now, he plays Jasper, you know, the vampire with certain powers, which you'll find out about here.
He's a cool dude, because I love it when they, when artists or actors, they just call in just to talk and say hi. Mm-hmm. Actually, he's kind of a fan of the show. He's been listening for a couple of weeks. Some people from Houston are working on the show, and they have the app, which is awesome. KRBE. App. It's really easy if you have an iPad or iPhone. Maybe you're with Verizon and they got the iPhone now and you didn't know about it. It's really simple.
All right, so
when he's been listening.
Yeah, when we spoke to him, we learned quite a few things, and there is a Houston connection.
Yeah,
so here's how it went down. Good morning, Jackson.
Good morning.
What's up, man?
Hey! Woo! So, you know, first of all, thanks so much because there are so many Twihards in the building right now. And, you know, Eric, I think you're even going to relinquish.
I'm a little under the weather here. So, Jackson, I'm going to let you talk to the biggest KRB Twilight fan here, Becca James from our station. She loves you, and I want her to be part of this interview. So I'm backing away. I'm going to let her be part of this because she loves you so much.
Oh, hey, Becca. How's it going?
Nice to meet you.
Oh, it's wonderful to meet you.
Well, I'll tell you what. You know, Rebecca knows more about Twilight than just about anybody in here.
Yes.
Mary, are you a Twilight fan as well?
I've seen the movies, but I'm not the diehard. She's read the books.
She has known every single thing about you. I mean, like almost restraining order crazy about you, okay?
Whoa. I'm just not that kind of an obsessive person. So
right, I'll tell you what. First of all, tell us a little bit about the movie, first of all. I mean, you know, when is this coming out?
Well, we're in the middle of Breaking Dawn Parts 1 and 2. We're filming both films consecutively. It's about a six-month shoot, and I think the first film will be coming out in November of this year.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a quick turnaround, but we're really excited to get it out to all the wonderful fans out there.
How long do we have to wait for Part 2?
Another year, sadly enough.
That's way too long.
There's a lot of CGI, a lot of amazing special effects that they're going to be putting into, especially in the second film. So,
well, I mean, how much different is this from, say, like, you know, like the previous films?
Well, the previous films, I think each film is very different from one another. You know, I mean, from the different directors, different styles. Twilight was an introduction to this vampire world. New Moon was an introduction to the werewolf world.
Yeah.
Eclipse was kind of a balance of how those worlds exist and can coexist,
right?
Against, you know, the Volturi. And then here in the final two chapters of Breaking Dawn, we get to see Bella transform into a vampire, and we get to see the consummation of the relationship between Edward and Bella, which I think everybody's been waiting on for a long time.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, trust me, you're going to see it.
All right, well, I got to ask you something, then. I'm going to let Rebecca take it away, but have you seen the parody Vampires Suck?
I have not. I've been meaning to check that out, though. It looks funny as hell.
Dude, I mean, it's so funny. It's, like, so right on. I mean, it's hilarious, but you know what? You know, I cannot do you justice right now, so Rebecca, go ahead and fire away. This is a true fan asking you a question.
All right, so online we've seen clips of rehearsals from the scene when you and Emmett are going to take Edward on his bachelor party. So will we get to see the bachelor party?
Well, you get to see a little bit of the bachelor party. I mean, we can't show you all of it. I mean, you know, what happens at the bachelor party stays at the bachelor party. You know what I'm talking about.
All right, so what are we going to get to see? Is it going to be crazy? I mean, how would you plan Edward's bachelor party?
With great secrecy.
Yeah, all Rebecca, right. He's got to keep a few secrets. Now, we're talking to Jackson Rathbone. Now, your character is Jasper. You know, how did you get involved with this in the first place? Like, I mean, how did you, you know, what was the, you know, were you freaked out when you auditioned for this? Did you have any idea it was going to be so huge?
Well, whenever I auditioned for the piece, I don't think the massive fan culture had built up. Once we were all cast and in Portland, I think all the fan sites started really jumping off, and it started getting a little crazy around that time once we started filming. But I got involved in this kind of on the ground level, and I was offered the role of Jasper, and Catherine Hardwick brought me into the studio and, you know, kind of talked me through the backstory and the entire mythology of this vampire universe she was creating with the first Twilight film. And it just sounded so exciting. And then my cousins all started calling me once I got the role, being like, oh, my God, you're in that movie?
That's pretty cool. Now, I know you're born in Singapore, correct?
That's correct.
But you spent time in Texas. Didn't you live in Midland?
I lived in Houston for a year as well.
Really?
I grew up about 4 or 5 years in Midland, Texas.
Oh, really? So what part of Houston?
Kingwood.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah.
So he's
I was in elementary school, actually. I think I was in fifth grade.
I wanted to ask you real quick, you know, you ever see yourself doing, like, the convention circuit or anything like that? Because, you know, you've got so many fans, and I know people do, like, mall appearances and things like that. And, you know, would you ever find yourself doing something like that, maybe?
Oh, yeah. I've done conventions in the past and probably will in the future as well.
We're talking to Jackson Rathbone, who plays Jasper in the new Twilight movie. Now, I got to ask you something really quick, okay? Because, you know, certain people, you know, fans of yours, I think everybody in this life has got a celebrity to-do list. And okay, so Rebecca, if you got permission from your husband and Jackson was willing, Jackson, would you do like a Make-A-Wish Foundation thing here for us?
Hold on.
That's a question right there. yeah, why not? Okay.
Oh, Jackson, that is so sweet. But, you know, I love my husband to death, and we don't have
I'm going to give you...
You should have come to me, though, you know, before y'all got married. I mean, you could have at least given me a chance.
One final question from Rebecca.
All right. Jasper's unique ability as a vampire is to control people's moods. In real life, if you had that ability, would you use that for good or for evil? And how?
Well, I think if you use that ability for evil, it might come back to bite you on the ass, so to speak. You know, it's one of those things you can't really...
Wait a second. Vampires don't bite on the ass, do they?
Negatively. Then it's going to come back at you. They're going to have a negative mood. I think if I can inspire people to always be in a good spirit and always have a good attitude and a good outlook on life, then I'd honestly be doing what the artist's job entails, which is to entertain and hopefully alleviate the modern stress of life.
Well, I got to thank you so much for taking time out. I mean, I know you've got a lot of fans. Yeah. You've got one girl in here, like, just blush red right now. And thank you so much, and we wish you continued success.
Are you the one girl who's blush red?
He is.
Yes, I am. You know what?
Oh, it's like, that's so sweet of you. Thank you.
Would you bite me?
Not on the book.
All right. Thanks so much. You know, we wish you the best of luck, and we'll talk to you soon, okay?
All right. Cheers, y'all. Have a good one.
And if you got a friend that didn't get to catch that, you can go to 104krbe.com. A lot of twihards out there. If you go to 104krbe.com, go to the Rule and Ryan page, and you can actually listen to that interview and
really
turn
cool
them
guy,
on to it.
Man.
Really
cool
nice guy.
I
really
love
nice
that he
guy.
Listens to, even though he only lived here like a year. It's pretty cool. He still has some roots here. He comes here a lot, performs with his band.
So if you're in fifth grade.
He listens
grade,
to us.
Yeah, if you're,
he was
100 Monkeys is the name
yep.
of the band.
They'll be coming
so,
to town.
Yeah, if you're in the fifth grade in Kingwood back in his day, then maybe you went to school with him.
Cool.
Okay, so come